Change is hard. And in the power and utilities world, a big change is underway and gathering pace, the energy transition. The energy transition is often described by the three Ds: decarbonization, using greener sources of energy, like wind and solar; decentralization, generating and managing power closer to the points of use rather than at distant power stations; and digitization, modernizing the information systems that make all of this possible. To adapt to all of this change, you might be tempted to follow the classic advice from American inventor, philosopher, and futurist Buckminster Fuller. Instead of trying to improve what exists, he'd say it's better to scrap the old entirely and replace it with the new. If only it were so simple here. Unfortunately, in most countries, while the power ecosystem is indeed very old, it would be exceptionally hard to replace. The existing grid is the product of decades, even a century, of steady expansion. Some describe the grid as the largest, most complex machine ever built. So, adapting to change, in this case, means making the old work with the new. And change is already here. For one, the overall demand for electrical power is rising. As people rely less on fossil fuels for heating their homes and powering their vehicles, our reliance on and demand for electricity will continue to grow. And at the same time, these changes are often not visible to electricity providers. Customers don't automatically tell their utility when they buy an electric vehicle, aka an EV, or when they install an electric heater. Plus, a host of new technologies are popping up at or near the service points, sometimes called the edge of the grid. These technologies are the so-called distributed energy resources, or DERs, like small wind farms, rooftop solar panels, in-home batteries, and smart thermostats. These DERs are changing customer power use patterns in unexpected ways. A home with an EV and rooftop solar is a totally different type of service point to plan for. DERs present both an opportunity and a challenge. The opportunity is that, if managed correctly, DERs will add new tools to the utility's toolkit, unlocking more ways to manage the ever-changing demand for power. Every rooftop solar panel is a potential power source, every EV battery a potential storage site. The challenge, however, is that making use of DERs will require new technologies and coordination. For example, software will be needed to send information to and from the devices. How much energy is stored in that EV battery right now? The collective project, led by a host of players and technologies to addressing these challenges, is often called grid modernization, or the smart grid. This primer will focus on two vital elements of this project. Firstly, the hardware involved, the DERs, and secondly, the software that will connect these DERs to the existing ecosystem, the Distributed Energy Resource Management Systems, or DERMS. The world of DERs and DERMS is in a state of rapid change. This primer will discuss both the future vision and the current reality, but the line between vision and reality can be blurry and varies market by market. In parts of Europe, for example, many of these systems are further along than in North America. And within North America, individual energy markets are themselves in different states of maturity along this spectrum. While many of these principles are universal, the details of how they are, and might soon play out, will vary.